are going bank fishing today. No, not an actual bank. I got word yesterday that the crappie were on in Shrewsbury. I get it. Today's a new day, but that's the only time I had to go fishing. So we're heading to Shrewsbury right now to see if we can get some crappie, and I'll show you the setup when we get there. See you in a minute. All right, guys, we are just about to arrive at our spot. The place I'm going to be fishing is obviously in Shrewsbury. It's a canal, and the particular canal is a dead end where I'm at. And it's a probably about, I'm going to say 20, 25 meters wide by about 200 feet long, 200 meters long, and it makes an L at the end. It takes you right out to the bay. So I'm hoping there ain't too many people there. It's Wednesday, so who knows.
There we go.
we had a great day fishing. I got 8 or 10 good crappie. I almost said good pickerel. Good crappie. For a Wednesday, I didn't think it was going to be as busy as it was. I'm surprised how many people don't work, but I didn't get a whole lot of camera angles like I wanted to, but people were crossing lines, and there's just a ton of people. There were some guys next to me that got about, I'm going to say about 40 between the two of them. I'm guessing now. But I got some pretty good slabs, so I'm going to head home, pick up Ella at school, then go home, have something to eat, clean up some fish. See you in a minute. All right, guys, we are back home, and here's what we got. So we ended up with 11. All of them pretty good size.
I'm never going to jump out of the boat like that because that's not good, right, Daddy?
There's two of the biggest ones. I'm going to show you what I used today, and it was pretty much an improvise. I'll tell you why. So first things first, obviously I'm using spinning gear. I got a quarter ounce jig head, just a white twister tail. Now, I didn't start out with that. I actually borrowed that one, and the reason is this. So what happened is I get down there, and obviously, part for the course, I brought the wrong box. So, I started out using this green quarter ounce jig head. But I needed a tail, so what I did was I improvised. So I had a single chartreuse twister tail. What I did was I cut it in half. Then I took the tail, cut part of the tail off. So now this is what I ended up with. I then take the jig head, sorry about that, thread it through just like a normal tail, and believe it or not, that's what I caught my crappie on right there. Sometimes I switched back to the white, but for the most part, all the crappie were caught on this setup right here. I was fishing them in about 5 feet of water. I got about 24 inches of bobber length from my bobber to the jig head, 24 inches. So I'm in about 3-4, sometimes 5 feet of water. The guys in the video that you see on the far shore, they had so many crappie that they just started playing around, and they were throwing crankbaits and catching crappie. Also on the spinning gear setup that I have here, I'm running 4-pound test line. Because the lighter line, the better. This rod is not exactly a crappie rod, but it worked today. So, 11 crappie later, got them all cleaned up. I spared you that. Spinning gear, 4-pound test line, quarter ounce yellow jig head with an improvised tail. And I'm having a good meal tomorrow. So I may or may not give it a shot tomorrow. We'll see how the day goes. I got a couple things I got to do in the morning. But having said all that, if you have already subscribed to our channel, thank you. If you haven't, make sure you hit the subscribe button, like button, share button. And as usual, ring that bell so that you get notified each and every time I upload a video. And until the next one, let's catch some fish. See you.